Lupe, good morning.
Good morning.
We're here with Lupe down here with Blue Moon Pools in San Diego, and we're about to plaster a pool, and we're going to record the whole thing to show how the best practices are to plaster a pool, document it. You see people taking pictures, you see them mixing it right on the truck, using calcium powder, things like that. And we're going to document it all for you today as a best practice example of how to plaster a pool. So explain, what are we doing here? What kind of plaster are we putting in, Lupe?
We're putting Primera Stone from Wettich.
Okay.
It's a polished pebble, and we're almost ready to start.
When you were here, I understand you take pictures of things and you document them. Is that correct?
Yes, I got pictures from since the salesman was here the first time, the demolition crew, the tile and coping. I got every day they take pictures.
Why do you take so many pictures and document it like that?
A lot of it is because I supervise in the mornings. I check whatever they did. And if there's anything that I see suspicious, then I go and take a look at it myself. Mm-hmm. For information, just in case something happened, I got documents that I can go back and check, right, and see what we did.
And that's the same with testing water chemistry out of the tap so that you know what's coming out of the tap before you even put your guys in the pool, right?
We always do that. It's very important to document those things, to check. To me, it solves more than 80% of the future problems in a plaster.
Wow, 80%. So tomorrow you're going to acid wash this and polish it, right?
We're going to polish it tomorrow, yes, and then we'll start the water. I normally add like a pound or two, mm-hmm, of calcium depending what the tap water readings are.
Right.
We started like that with Orenda Sequest. That has been working very well for me.
Good, I'm glad. So what we did was we're using the Orenda calculator to figure out exactly how much calcium needs to be on site. And this pool, I think you said it was 150 calcium.
Yes.
So we do the math, and as long as we get LSI balanced a little bit on the high side, we will know exactly how much calcium and bicarbonate needs to be here tomorrow. And your guys actually add it before the pool's even full.
Yes, we add it when the pool has like about approximately 300 gallons. Mm-hmm. We add like a pound or two in there. The first thing that we do when we start with a startup is check the pool water to see where it is at that moment, mm-hmm, and then we raise it to whatever it needs to be.
Okay. Wonderful.
We want it at least at 230, okay, parts per million.
230 parts per million on day one, even before the water is completely full.
Yes, ideally, yes. We're going to feed the calcium to the water if it, mm-hmm, needs it.
That's good. So just kind of to recap, Lupe is cutting edge on this because here's the thing about water. It wants to be in equilibrium, as we've studied with the LSI, that you have two choices. You can give it the calcium that it craves, or it's going to steal it from wherever it can get it. And on a fresh plaster job, there's all that white cement, which is loaded with calcium. It's just going to steal it from the surface. We could prevent that problem by giving the water the calcium that it needs rather than letting the water steal it. Lupe, I want to thank you so much for having us here.
Thank you, guys.
This is great. We got some great footage here today.
Thank you.
I'm Eric with Orenda. This is Lupe with Blue Moon Pools, leading the charge on how to plaster correctly. Thanks so much for your time.